that our romance is true. I'll never love again. I'm so in love with you.
So good of you to come.
Mind if I get something from the car?
No, of course not. I'll have Jeffrey help you.
Meet Professor Archibald Mord, a scientist. He has been invited to a dinner party by Miss Marilyn May. Miss May has asked him to bring an invention with which to entertain the guests. However, while Professor Mord, Miss May, and the others will enter the party quite unassumingly, they will exit into the Twilight Zone.
But please, call me Archie.
All right, I think I can do that. Now let me show you around. Hey, you guys, I'd like to introduce you to a friend of mine. Archie, these are my friends Gwen, Roy, and his fiancée Gloria.
What do you think about this guy, huh? He's dancing with my girl.
Your girl? She flirts with everyone she sees. She's just a tease.
Well, ain't gonna be that way for long, I'll tell you that.
Ahem! Dinner is served.
Like.
Did everybody get the vegetables?
Pumped Morris, can I have the pears?
Yes.
I know what pot looks like, there's not so much that's going on.
So, Doc.
Well, actually, it's different.
I don't you hurt yourself. You need to loosen up a little. You just sit around your house and build mysterious inventions all day?
No, I'm. There's probably more in my life. I just tend to be more of a reserved person. Especially with people I've never met.
Well, hey, you know me now, don't you? You should be talking easy with me now. And all these other guys, they're regular people. Let me see.
Those two offers are pretty ordinary. Gloria's a little more reserved than her husband, but if you get to know her, she's real
that's
nice. And the same goes on with Roy, although he's a little more talkative than this little woman. See him over there? He's a real rich guy, and pretty skeptical about a lot of things too. He probably just came out here tonight to see your new invention, and probably gotta find a way to prove that it's all fake.
And what is that guy over there? Tony, right?
Tony?
His little friend?
Oh, yeah, I can't say much about his character. But I wouldn't prod too much on his business. He's actually into a little bit of organized crime, and that little guy over there, his name's Al. He's just kind of Tony's sidekick. He just keeps him around in case of any trouble.
Hopefully that doesn't have any problems to me. I saw my ball and you mean Marilyn not when we were dancing.
I wouldn't worry about it. He's always looking at somebody.
So, who's the one with the Model A out there?
Oh, that'd be mine.
You? Why? The car's gotta be like 20 years old by now.
Well, you see, I don't have much need for a new car, and I don't really have the money to buy a new one, so I guess it gets me where I need to go.
Well, to each his own, I guess.
Well, I suppose most of you are wondering exactly what my machine does. The machine I've created is a machine that can communicate with the dead. It is sort of like a seance, except a little more reliable, and with the comfort of science to back up its reliability.
How exciting! We must try it, Archie.
As you wish, Merlin. As you wish. Yes, I seem to be hearing a voice now. Hold on, it's a little faint. There it is. It's coming in better now. We appear to have an Uncle Fred talking now.
I had an uncle named Alfred.
He seems to want me to relay a message to you. Yes. He wants me to tell you to get a new profession and to invest in something called platform shoes.
Oh, I'm glad that old man croaked!
Now, Al, this is a party. We don't need any discourtesy. We're all friends here.
Seems to be picking something else up. The grandmother of James?
This is preposterous. I don't believe you. Here, let me hear.
James, I love you. We'll meet again one day.
Well then, anyway, let's try another. I'm gonna see if I can increase the power and get a clear signal.
So what do you think about this guy, huh? He danced with my girl.
Girl. I'm going to kill Marilyn. Tonight, she dies.
Oh.
Archie? Arch, what is it?
Nothing. It's nothing. Enough of the machine for now. Let's just enjoy the party.
I'm going.
What do you think about this guy, huh? Dance with my girl. To kill.
Hey, Marilyn, you wanna go with this man?
So what happened on this fateful evening?
Sir,
was the professor reading
exactly
the mind of Tony? Did he subconsciously have the plan to kill Marilyn all along? Or was there some sort of evil force that was inside the machine that needed only a puppet to do its work? The world might never know what really happened in the Twilight Zone.
Until I smile at you, I'll never laugh again. What good would it do? For tears would fill my eyes. My heart would realize that all